I see seed systems, maize and legumes. And as mentioned, if you have any reference material, you can put that in the green post-its as well. So that would be also helpful. Input systems, I see. Irrigation. Thank you. Inputs. Seed systems. Maize legumes. Rice intensification, sustainable intensification, shorter supply lines, urban agriculture, primary education and support, availability of sweet potato virus clean plants. That's quite interesting. Inputs, I see inputs is being repeated. Seed systems and women empowerment. Breeding networks, is that more of like education and research, or it would be good to clarify?
Are you the Global Genomics Assisted Breeding Networks?
Yes, yes.
We just work with several teams in Ethiopia, Niger, and Senegal. And we've developed networks for genomics assisted breeding through those local organizations. Farmers, end users, researchers.
And would you consider that like a priority system, like research basically would be within the crop production system, research would be a priority system, the research system in general?
I would consider that, yes. Okay. There's more information in the link that I provided too.
Okay. And in terms of leverage points within the system, what needs to be, to bring about change, for instance, in the research system, where would you start? What would you lever to bring about transformative change? I don't mean to put you on the spot, but I think we also need to consider, as we identify the different systems, what are the key barriers within the system and what needs to be done within those systems. And that's what we mean by leverage points. What are the key things that we need to change within those systems?
Was that a question for everyone?
Yes. If you have any answers, of course you're welcome to say your ideas or put it on the Jamboard. Leverage points.
I want to suggest soil health, but I don't know how to add it.
Soil health.
Okay. Or crop production.
Okay, I'll put that here.
So I have a question.
Yes, please.
So in the leverage points, what do you mean? Like we need to just say high, low, medium, or?
No, so within the systems that have been identified, what are the key things that need to be changed to bring about transformative change? Where should you take targeted action within those systems that are identified?
Like based on my priority system, am I right?
What are exactly, the exactly. Within the priority system that you have identified, where should the change happen?
Okay, thank you.
So for soil health, I would also add a payment to farmer for carbon sequestration.
Okay. If I may, Rahel, I was the one writing down about the system of rice intensification, and I think a leverage point for further research could be, well, of course, focus on context-specific implementation of this system, but also on the combination of the system of rice intensification with other agroecological practices, like, for example, conservation agriculture, agroforestry, which is something that is sometimes overlooked, the combination of different agroecological practices and the results that can bring. And well, of course, to bring this into action, we need to work with policymakers and whoever has the capacity to implement at scale.
Okay, thank you, Francesco.
Yeah, if no other contribution are there, if I can add, for
yes,
example.
Yes, please, go ahead.
Yeah, an opportunity is given from the NDCs, the National Determinate Contributions, and for SRI, the System of Rice Intensification, of course, if this will be included by countries in their NDCs, will help to scale these practices that can mitigate methane emission while ensuring food security and nutritional security. But then, for example, other action could be to have supportive policies for SRI uptake in different countries and to build on previous and current SRI project. And I'm talking about SRI because this is my work, but as I mentioned before, agroecology at large should be introduced and more supported by policy environments in each and every state and by international institutions.
Okay.
I don't know
Thank you. Any
participants have any feedback of yourself want to discuss on this. I would be glad to hear other participants.
Yeah. If you could put any evidence or reports that you have in the like using the green sticky notes, that would help us.
They are already there. I think that okay. The third one is full of links about that.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. I see. Focus on nutrition rather than volume. That's quite interesting. Who put that in? If you would like to expand on that, we would appreciate it. I think that's a very important point. Not just focusing on yield, but nutrition.
Yes, thank you. This is John Maidendorp. I put that note there. We focus very much on yields and producing more food. But the attention that we pay to nutrition is perhaps not as central to our planning as it ought to be. I think that we need to focus more on ensuring that there are nutritional spectrums of diets available, especially in growing urban populations. There are a lack of sources of nutritional food in urban centers. And unless we start paying attention to supplying the entire nutritional spectrum, we're going to end up having deficiencies in diets and other problems such as obesity, even in the midst of hunger. So I think focusing on nutrition rather than simply focusing on the production of food would be an important change of approach. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
very important.
I wanted
to contribute also. Can I contribute also?
Yes, please.
Okay. Yeah, thank you so much. I'm Kaganga John, and I'm based in Uganda. I'm a farmer, but the methodology we use in farming is more of agroecology and then also nature-based conservation or action, which is almost more related. But the more concern I have is in crop production. We have been talking so much about crop production alone. As someone said, we need also nutrition and so many things. But again, I can give an example in Uganda. This crop, I mean, after producing, what is next? Because distribution, we usually overlook the distribution. We need to have some more research on how, when the food or the crops, I mean, the food or whatever you are producing is produced. How do you distribute it in the country? How do you market it? How do you, and then what is the quality and what is the quantity? Because now I am just giving a briefly an example of what is happening in Uganda, that there are some areas in our country, people are dying of hunger, whereas some areas within the country, moreover, have a lot of print of food. Therefore, distribution, we need a lot of research on distribution, and then marketing, and then also the quality, the quantity, all of those should be looked into at, so that the farmers, especially now I say I'm the farmer, should be guided. Because if they are not guided by the researchers, things cannot be working very well. The production will not succeed. That's what I wanted to contribute.
Thank you so much for that. I think we have captured that in the Jamboard as well. Please go ahead. We also need to
within the board. Sorry, it's Phil Gaffney. I'm based in the UK. On the board, there's no mention anywhere in crop production about fertilizers and the fact that, well, they're ridiculously expensive worldwide at the minute. But we have major worldwide issues on the availability of them. And for instance, the natural resources are going to be running out. There's maybe 50 years worth of phosphorus left on the planet for mining. So we have to look at and fully engage with other ways to reduce fertilizer usage. Now, I'm obviously quite biased towards getting away from purely chemical fertilizer because our company manufactures biostimulants. But there are lots of natural fertilizers out there that can be utilized as well. And it's something that the other members of the group aren't focusing on that much, you know, and not just use of fertilizers, but proper use of fertilizers. We mainly work within Africa, South America, and a little bit in Asia. And the education aspect of proper fertilizer usage is lacking, let's go with. And it's something that needs to be expanded quite greatly.
Yeah, I think that that's a very important point. Unfortunately, we need to transition to the out of the breakout rooms. So just to, I mean, there is a lot already, as you can see on the Jamboard. But to summarize quickly, I heard and also saw on the Jamboard about input systems, including fertilizer systems that need to be, that are key in the crop production system. Research education, including farmer education, is key. In terms of the leverage points, soil health and carbon sequestration is a leverage point, a key leverage point that has been raised. The focus on nutrition and not just volume of production is another key point that has been raised. And in the systems also, both in the system and leverage point, we heard about sustainable intensification, including sustainable rice intensification. So this will be, I think, the main points that in finance, another one is finance is a key leverage point for transformation. Alfredo, I see your hand up. We have maybe a minute before we transition. Go ahead.
Yes, I'm Fredo Rueda from Honduras. One important point is to make changes on production. We need land tenure, secure land tenure for the farmers, because no farmers want to invest in the land that they don't own, and they cannot prepare properly for a resilient systems. And the other part is a good production system that we have experimented in Honduras is the water harvesting reservoirs, rain-fed water harvest reservoirs to start irrigated agriculture so they can increase productivity and resilience on the system. Thank you.
Thank you. Any last minute as we transition to the main room?
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Go ahead. This is Douglas. Douglas called from Ghana.
Okay. Go ahead, Douglas.
Yes. What I want to say is that if you come to Ghana, they have Ghana Cocoa Board, who buy cocoa products from every village as a every village where they have the office from village to the national level. But in the other crop production, we don't have marketing structure from the village, the farm gate to the national level. Because all are part of crop production. If you're able to set up that chain or that command or that marketing structure, it can also increase the production. Where the farmer produces the thing, he can send the goods somewhere place to buy it. So they can also record and get so they can also get the data, full data of any production we produce in the farm gate. Hello?
Yes, thank you.
You're sorry, but yes.
Yes, okay. Please, I don't know if you haven't put that point on the Jamboard, please do so. Thank you.